chemistry has some very large numbers and some very small numbers. And one way of simplifying those numbers is to use what we call scientific notation. Here's a number expressed in scientific notation, 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd. The 23rd is called the exponent, and it's the number of times that the 10 is used to that power. Six with the decimal after it, that's the standard position for the decimal. And when we have an exponent that's positive, it indicates that the true position of the decimal lies that many places to the right. So if we were to convert this number in scientific notation to its regular long form that you might be more familiar with, we'd need to move the decimal 23 places to the right. If I did that, well, we could move it 1 and 2. There'd be 21 more zeros after that 602. Indeed, a very large number. So it greatly simplifies things, and it's a lot easier sometimes if we use scientific notation. If I had a number that was less than 1, then this exponent would be negative. And again, the exponent indicates the number of places that the decimal should be moved. So if I have a number 8.7 times 10 to the minus 3, it's telling me the true position of the decimal lies 3 places to the left. If I were to move it in front of the 8, then I'd need 2 more zeros to express that in the regular form. These two numbers are equivalent. I'll call this one the regular form and this one the one in scientific notation. And sometimes I use the term correct scientific notation. That simply means that the decimal is after the first digit. There are a number of skills associated with scientific notation, and if you were to make predictions about what would be on quizzes and exams, it's a good idea. Well, there are two categories of questions, concepts, and then there are skills. And I think I could list 5 skills that we'd like you to have in scientific notation. You can make your own list of skills within a chapter, and it's a great, great way of preparing for an exam. I would say that it's important to be able to convert a number into scientific notation. And the reverse, taking one in scientific notation and converting it back to the regular form. Sometimes when you're multiplying and dividing and manipulating numbers in scientific notation, you end up with a number that's expressed to a power, 10 to the something. It's in scientific notation, but it's not really in correct scientific notation. The decimal isn't after the first digit. So we'd like you to have that skill. And then to be able to multiply and divide numbers in scientific notation. Let's look at each of those skills for a moment. If I have the number 4,870 and would like to convert that into scientific notation, I'd write 4, then the decimal immediately after that first digit, the rest of the number, times 10 to the something. That's the easy part. And then maybe it's this exponent that would cause you a little bit of difficulty. Again, it's a number greater than 1, so our exponent's going to be positive. I've moved the decimal 3 places. It was here, even though it's not shown, right after the 0. I've moved it to the left 3 places. Because these two numbers are equal, I would balance that by indicating to the right in the exponent. And maybe you have your own way of moving the decimal and coming up with the correct exponent up there. And if you have a way that works good, why, use whatever way works for you. The point that I'd like to emphasize here, though, is that it's really easy to check your work. And that's what you want to do. You could even take a guess as to the exponent and then check your work and see if it makes sense. So if I have this number in scientific notation and the exponent is 3, that tells me that the true position is 3 places to the right, 1, 2, 3, and indeed the two numbers would be the same. Here's a number involving a negative exponent. Scientific notation, I'd like to convert it to the long form. This minus 2 tells me that the true position is 2 places to the left, so let's do that. 1 would be in front of the 1. I'd need one more 0, so here's our answer. This first 0, of course, is really meaningless, but it does have some usefulness. It clarifies the position of the decimal. Well, that's one scale. 2 scales, actually. We've taken a number in regular form to scientific notation. We've taken the number in scientific notation to the regular form. Down here, I've listed 2 numbers now that we could say are in scientific notation, but they're not in correct scientific notation. The decimal needs to be after the first digit. So let's do that. 1.41 times 10 to the something, that's the easy part. Well, let's see what we're doing. This indicates that the true position is 3 places to the left. We've moved the decimal 1, 2, 2 places to the left. So we've taken care of two of those out of the 3, which means that it's just now 10 to the minus 1. And again, check this. You could convert both of these to the long form and verify that indeed they're the same number. Let's look at this one. 283.6 times 10 to the third. Put the decimal after the first digit. Now it's going to be in correct scientific notation, times 10 to the something. Going to move the decimal 2 places to the left. I'd balance that by indicating 2 more places to the right. So 2 and 3 make 5. 2.836 times 10 to the fifth. Let's move on now to our next scale. Let's multiply and divide numbers in scientific notation. Here's a pretty typical problem. This is a multiplication problem. 2.4 times 10 to the minus 3 times 1.8 times 10 to the fifth. Some of you have calculators that this wouldn't present any difficulty whatsoever. Your calculator probably handles exponents well, and you're experienced at manipulating exponents. For some of you, however, you may not have a calculator that does that, or you might not be familiar with it, or you might just be a little insecure about the process. And for you, what I've done is to rearrange this problem into 2.4 times 1.8 times 10 to the minus 3 times 10 to the fifth. Because now these two numbers, you can multiply in the normal way in your calculator. And what we're going to do is to evaluate the exponent manually, or in our heads. And the rule for multiplying exponential numbers is that exponents are added. So we're going to add a minus 3 and 5, and the answer is 10 to the 2. It's the sign of the larger. If they're different signs, it's the sign of the larger and the difference between the two numbers. So this comes out to 10 to the 2. This is our answer. But we need to go one more step further. In our next video, we'll talk about significant figures. And here, 2.4 and 1.8 are 2 significant figures each. We need to round 4.32 to 2 significant figures. And that turns out to be 4.3 times 10 to the 2. That's a pretty typical problem. For sure, there'll be something like that on your exam. So on your exam sheet or your notes as you prepare for an exam, put something like this down. That would be a great prediction. Let's do a division problem. Here's a pretty typical division problem with scientific notation. The exponent up above is positive, down below it's negative. there'd be all sorts of possibilities. We could have two positives, two negatives, and so on. So you want to practice with each of those variations as you prepare for an exam. Again, like we did with multiplication, I'm going to rearrange this division problem. If you've got a calculator that and you're confident of handling the exponents, hey, great, you're all set. But if you have a little bit of doubt, you can rearrange the problem and put the 1.8 times over 2.4, separate it from the two exponents. Let's evaluate each of these separately. On my calculator, this turned out to be 0.75. And now the rule for division of exponential numbers is that it's the numerator minus the denominator. So a plus 5 minus a minus 3, that changes the sign into a plus 3, and we add. So it comes out 10 to the 8th. Another little trick that you might keep in mind is that what we're really doing is moving this 10 to the minus 3 up into the numerator. And any time you cross that line, the exponent changes sign. So as I take the 10 to the minus 3 up, it becomes a plus 3. A plus 3 and a plus 5 are a plus 8. Well, here's our answer. And it's in scientific notation. But remember, one more step. Let's put it into correct scientific notation. The decimal after the first digit, 7.5 times. And because the 8 indicates that the true position of the decimal is 8 places to the right, we're taking care of one of those as we move to the right. So the new exponent is 10 to the 7th. Well, if you'd like more practice with these skills, with scientific notation, look at the end of the chapter. The tutor CD has some that you can practice on. And at the end of the chapter, the even exercises are answered in the back. So you'll be able to check your work. And again, when you have questions, email me or give me a call if you need help.